Scene.
So, I was on a llama farm when it happened.
Calm down, sweetie. We're not there yet. Let's start with your name.
Hi, everyone. I'm Lucille.
Hi, Lucille.
And this is my story. So, every Tuesday afternoon at 2 o'clock, I always go to yoga class. Now, this is a very special yoga class. You see, it's led by llamas. Now, 30 minutes in, I was doing the downward dog position when out of the corner of my eye, I see a large poop ball running towards me, and it kicks me in my dang knocker. So, I'm pretty sure it broke my dang skull, but I just can't remember. And next thing I know, I'm here with y'all. Definitely not a highlight of my day.
And how did that llama make you feel?
How did it make me feel? How do you think it would feel getting kicked in your noggin by a llama? Definitely did not feel like a bowl of chicken and dumplings, if you ask me.
Thank you for sharing, Lucille.
And that's the last time I ever go to yoga with llamas. They can kiss my...
Hey! Erskine, why don't you go next?
Right then. Well, my story begins in my shire of Drummond. Well, one day I was walking through my shire, right? And it was a really nice day, so I thought I'd go for a walk. Well, I saw my friends in the corner of my eye. They were playing log toss, and I wanted to go join them. So I walk over, and as I'm walking, my kilt starts to sway in the wind because it's starting to pick up, but I don't think much of it. So I start walking, and my friends, they start to bow to me as I walk over. And this huge gust of wind comes up and takes my kilt right off. And I mean, I don't know what to do, but they just look very frightened when they look up, and so I asked my friend to give me his kilt so that I can keep my modesty. Well, we continue to play log toss, and we keep playing, and my kilt's swaying again, and I'm freaking out because the wind starting to pick up again. A giant gust comes right back. Well, I'm able to keep my kilt, however, my first kilt comes back and hits me in the face and knocks me aback. And I hit my head on the back of a log, and I don't really remember what happened till then. It took my breath away.
I'm sure it did.
My, what a wonderful story. Kelly, would you like to end our discussion today?
If I have to. Hi, I'm Kelly.
Hi, Kelly.
Okay, so I work as a barista at Starbucks. And this guy comes in, he's like, I want a double mocha latte with 2 half pumps of caramel and the foam in the shape of a heart. And I'm like, sure. What name can I put on the cup, sir? And he looks me dead in the eyes and says, I'm Batman. I'm not writing that on the cup, sir. Anyways, we fight about it for a while until I finally write his name on the cup and I go to make his coffee. So I'm making the coffee and the machine's doing this weird thing where the coffee's sputtering. I don't think much of it and I go back to give him his coffee. I stand there going, I have a double mocha latte for Batman. Is there a Batman here? God, I hate my job. So I give him his coffee and go back to take the next order when the machine starts going crazy with these sparks and everything, so I run over and try to fix it, and I wake up here, being a little tingly.
Really starting to see you open up, Kelly?
Sure.